Hey guys, here's my next project. I thought I'd do a little how-to, if you will. Not that I'm very good at this stuff, but I'm getting better, I think. And it's on the Orc Battlewagon. I've started to assemble and paint. Just so you guys know, how I do it is straight black, just your chaos black spray can. Some guys will buy generic stuff that is cheaper, and so be it. I just find that this stuff works really good, dries quickly, so I've always had good luck with it. So straight black, and then the next color is, what I do is I mix half, 50% chaos black, 50% bolt gun metal, and it gives you this really, really dark silvery, and then you just dry brush it. And the brush that I actually use is something like this, and it's just essentially dry brushing over. And I'm working on the tracks. I did the tracks the same black and then that heavy, heavy gray. And this track is almost done, where I use regular bolt gun metal. So I don't know if the camera will pick that up or not, but you'll see the difference between this and in between that. So this is what it's going to look like. Now obviously there's lots of weathering, tons of painting to be done to this, but for the basic colors, that's what it's looking like. And that's not what I'm showing you though. What I want to show you today is this. This is going to be the front of the battle wagon. And this piece here you can get from Forge World, and I think it's $9, $10, and it comes with this ring on it. So I cut this ring off, I made some green stuff around it, and used this as a template to press all around, and now I just want to make the big hair. So what I'm doing is I mixed up a bunch of green stuff, and break a little piece off and just roll it some spot where it's nice and clean, because it'll pick up debris. That's happened to me a few times. And just roll it out until it's nice and thin. So I'm hoping it'll turn out good. The paint scheme that I paint my orcs is the Evil Sun. So the hair, I plan on going from red to yellow. So here would be an example. Once you get it down, then just break it off and do it again. Still not fine enough, so break it off again and roll this one, and then that one should be good. So, what I'm doing is just using my fingernail to push down to hold it, and I like using a cheap dental tool thing here, curve it around, give it a little push so it sticks on something. And essentially, it'd be nice if they were all long enough to keep going, but for me, I'm not that good. So I just break it off and add strands here and there. So this one I'll add to the end. And just tie it in somehow. So that's a sneak peek of what the battle wagon front's going to look like. I hope you like it. Hopefully this inspired you a little bit to step outside the box. Don't just paint it the way they provide it. For a couple extra bucks, you can really make this battle wagon stand out, something that nobody else has. And I'm going to keep working on that. I really want to build this up here, and then somehow I'll form the little stub there that will come out of his forehead to hold this in place. That'll probably just be forming the screen stuff. So hopefully you like it, guys. I'm interested to see how this is going to turn out. relatively inexpensive once you have the battle wagon, and green stuff, this icon is about $10 from Forge World. I think the most it kills you is the shipping from there, so I ordered a bunch when I ordered a couple. Or when I ordered one, I think I ordered three of them, so that I have them here. Anyhow, leave a comment. Let me know what you think. Hopefully I'm not wasting my time on